Alright, let's do the helper video number 8. Alright, so starting out with what is the electronic configurations for Ni2+. So for the ion, you're supposed to take off the electrons from the outside. That means at that highest N. So let me just take a look at this Ni right here. That's atomic number 28, right? So 1s squared, well actually no, it's okay. 2s squared 2p6, 3s squared 3p6, and then there's the 4s squared 3d8, I believe that was 8, wasn't it? Yep. So if you check the total number of electrons, I have 10 and 10 and then 28, right? So D8 you always start out with a neutral first. So Ni neutral looks like this, with the 4s being filled like right here. 4s 3d, right? And then you're taking two electrons, right? So now you're taking two electrons from this guy right here, because S has a higher value of N, right? So doing the shorthand notations, that is AR, with the 4S is gone completely. Well, actually, let's do this with the nickel plus. Nickel plus is a 4s with a 3d8, and then nickel 2 plus is a AR with a just 3d8, because 4s to the power of 0 is just 1. So alright, that's good. Let's do the next problem. What is the largest, I think this is in size, comparing B with the 3 electrons attached, or carbon with 2 electrons attached, or the nitrogen with the 1 extra electron, so the oxygen neutral. All of these things, by the way, is they all have the same number of electrons, if you notice that. So B right here is this guy, right? That's atomic number 5. So number of electrons for this guy right here, B 3- is 5+3, right? That's 8, right? And then carbon 2-, that's 6+2, that's also 8. N- is 7+1, it's also 8. Oxygen is just 8. And then fluorine plus is 9-1, oops, 9-1, that's also 8. And then neon 2+ is also 8. So all of these guys having the same number of electrons, right? But what's the nuclear charge? Nuclear charge is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, right? Those are the positive in the middle, right? So higher the positive value in the middle, it's gonna get smaller. So this neon 2 plus is gonna be the smallest. That one is gonna be the largest in size. Okay, that's good enough. Alright, let's do the next problem. Okay, should I do this? Yeah, I think I should do it. Getting used to Excel is kind of important, so let me just try to prepare myself with alright, so I'm ready. So the formula is n equal 2, that's Ni. Let's just put Ni here. And then this is gonna be NF. That's the destinations. And let's just say that I'm gonna put it as a 3 right here. for the first one. Then the delta E is equal to minus 2.18 e to the negative 18 multiplied by 1 over nf squared minus 1 over ni squared. So that's the joule energies here. So going from the 2s to 2s to 3d, let me just write it, 2s to 3d, you need that much energies. And if I were to actually going from the 2 to 100, then you need that much energies. I'm just gonna copy this number by here, right here, and then just try to check the same stuff here. So let me just try to copy the whole thing here. Copy and then paste. Right. So I'm gonna change this one to 1,000 here. What's gonna happen? Do you see any difference here? Not much, right? It's a very small number change from here to here. If this is going from the 2 to 3 and then 2 to 4, there is a significant change here, right? But if you're going from the 2 to 1,000, for example, and then 2 to 2,000, these numbers are nearly identical. So if you put 1 million, then that number is pretty much the same numbers as this one. Like it's nearly the same, right? So, and that number right here, let me just try to show you what this means, is that I've already done with that particular problem. But if you're going to the really, really large numbers here, then you're putting the really large number here. And 1 over a large number is nearly 0, right? So that whole thing right here, delta E is nearly 2.18 times 10 to the negative 18, that constant, multiplied by 0 minus 1 over ni squared, which is 0, we just gonna ignore that one. Then that minus minus is gonna cancel, 2.18 times 10 to the negative 18, 1 over ni squared. And that's pretty much the energy required to knock off the electrons, which is approximated by that number right here. What it looks like is that you have this potential energies. Oops, that's not good. Let me just try to take the things. So that's the distance between. Or maybe the rest of the stuff. The stuff to one electron that you're ripping it off. Right, so this is the outermost electron. So as the distance between the outermost electron increase, the energy is gonna increase, but it's not increase forever, right? Because you're separating one of, just like 1 over r, like 1 over r, if the r gets close to infinity, this number is going to be close to 0, right? So eventually this number is going to approach to 0, like so, right? And then the ionization energies, the energy required to go from here to here, all the way down, that's the ground state, to right here. So the very first n equal maybe 2 or something like that, then equal 3, and then 4, 5, 6, 7, and then the things get crowded here, and n equal infinity, yeah, very close to right here. That's zero, by the way, happened to be. So if you put the n equal infinities, that means that you're literally taking off the electrons from the rest of the bodies. I think that's good enough.